I'm making a broad presentation of the situation of rural enterprises promotion in Kerala. My name is Reghu Rama. I'm from Trivandrum, most southern tip of India. I think very few people are here from south, especially from Kerala. So I'll be presenting primarily the opportunities and challenges related to micro enterprises. Not only Mitraniketan experiences, I will also talk to you about the experience of Kerala in relation to Kudumbashree. Briefly about my organization, it's called Mitraniketan. It has a connection with the Shantiniketan. This institute started in the year 1956 by Mr. Vishwanathan. He was a student of Shantiniketan and spent many years in Sevagram. And it's a community having a 60-acre land with a lot of activities, basically development education activities. We are promoting rural development through development education. So I'm not taking much of the time in relation to my organization. I will go ahead with the rural enterprises. So I will primarily talking about the challenges, problems in relation to promotion of micro enterprises. Primarily one of our basic problem is in relation to labor. Kerala has the lowest labor which one has to pay for any work is 500 rupees. A manual unskilled labor, young people, their own worth more than less than 750 rupees. Skilled labors are, for example, we have a bakery, Christmas is coming, we invited a baker for making cake and all. He said for 6 hours, 1,200 rupees. So minimum 100 rupees per hour, it becomes like that for labor cost. So that is one of the problems of enterprise, rural enterprises promotion. Secondly, you know, many of the young, educated, skilled people in Kerala, they migrate to Middle East countries. You know, what happened is we have now 4 international airports. On an average of 10 flights are going to different Middle East countries and coming back. So we also have a problem with the replacement migration. It's not a problem, it's a really help. We have lots of 3 million workers from Bihar, Orissa, Bengal and Assam working in Kerala. But they are partly skilled workers. They are engaged in some other work also, not connected with any enterprise. Mostly construction related activities, you know. In addition to that, people are not, they are hesitant to take risk. For example, those people coming back from Middle East countries, they have a lot of money, they may not be interested to invest in enterprises, productive activities. What they do is they build construction, build houses and rent it out for similar activities without risk which they are doing. So and also when you start an enterprise or a small activity which feel it is commercial, then there will be a lot of taxes in all different ways. In the case of electricity, water or panchayat tax, licenses, everything is in commercial line, so it is in the beginning, it is not an affordable. That is also a challenge. Then of course, the poor market linkage, of course there is market, but linkage in the rural, urban is very poor. Similarly, access to technologies. Now I go directly to the potentials. What are the potentials in general in Kerala? We have a lot of local resources available. You know, Kerala is known for coconut, rubber, banana and related crops and also spices. But let us say half of the area is now almost covered with rubber. So we are getting every farmer, every rubber farmer is getting income every day. Almost 90%, 95% of the rubber latex is directly sold as a raw material. Very few value addition or industries connected with rubber is there. That is one of the big problem. At the same time, it is a potential also. Similarly, we have a sufficient resource centers, research centers, training centers run by government and other institutions which will provide skill development as well as technologies and also quality control support for updating knowledge and all. Those are also resources and potential which can be taken up for promoting rural enterprises. Similarly, we have a number of self-help groups run by the government as well as run by NGOs and other agencies. That is also a big potential because they have the resources. Similarly, farmers group all over the state, small farmers group is also there. So agri-based industries, there is a lot of scope. Now we come to Kudumbashree. Kudumbashree, you know, in Kerala, it is actually, Kudumbashree is primarily women-led poverty eradication program run by the government, poverty eradication mission of the government of Kerala. It's called Kudumbashree. Kudumbashree is primarily from lower level to upper level. It is organization of women. We used to call it neighborhood groups. Neighborhood groups is actually 20 women from 20 houses in the villages form neighborhood groups or self-help groups. These self-help groups, as you were talking, in every ward, they organized into a number of neighborhood groups. All these neighborhood groups in the ward forms ADS or Area Development Society. So all these wards in a panchayat forms Community Development Societies. In Kerala, we have a little more than 1,000 panchayats and there are 1,000 Community Development Societies of women. So Kudumbashree is primarily focusing three things in Kerala. One is microcredit, saving and credit program. Second one is empowerment of women. There are many activities for the development of women. And the third one is promoting rural enterprises. So one of the main focus of Kudumbashree is rural enterprises promotion. I will explain to you how they promote rural enterprises. Primarily, you know, I told you there are 2.77 lakhs of neighborhood groups we have. They are from 45 lakhs of household, 45 lakhs of families. All these members of these micro enterprises are encouraged to take up micro enterprises. All these women members of the Kudumbashree are motivated to take up rural enterprises utilizing internal resources, internal savings, local resources, as well as formal aided training programs and support services. So totally the whole women involved in the Kudumbashree process are motivated to promote enterprise. Then I will tell you how we are Kudumbashree is promoting enterprises. First is primarily through consultants. We have a lot of micro enterprises consultants. They are not come from management institutes. They are just village women. We have a lot of educated women. All those village women are being trained, selected from the village, trained, continuously trained and placed in the village itself as micro enterprises consultants. So we have about 350 women working all over the state as consultants. So they are giving support service to the groups, women groups. These are the support services given by these consultants. You can read it. Primarily, they help them to identify the right business opportunities. Also, they are imparting training programming skills, entrepreneurship skills. They help to develop business plans. They link them with the credit facilities. They are also helping them to start or setting up of enterprises and also link for market. At the same time, they are also monitoring, that is what is called performance tracking, and giving necessary advice whenever it is required. Similarly, the training is being given in the case of bookkeeping and accounting. This is the services these women consultants are being provided. Then the second support service is given by the Kudumbashree is skilling and management services. The skilling and management services, they are generally giving orientation on rural enterprises to all women members of these women group. That means almost 45 lakhs of women are being covered through this process. Then selected people, they are giving entrepreneurship development training program. Then based on the enterprise, they are going to start their skill development training program. It's on a regular basis, not at a stretch. And also performance improvement training for those people who have initiated these small enterprises. In addition to that, support is given for auditing and accounting work by these management experts. The third service is technical and financial services. That is the third group which is giving to all these small women groups. That is primarily giving capital to startups. And also, they are giving soft loans and interest subsidy also. Then second, those assistance. That means once the enterprise is coming up well, then they are giving the second phase of capital support. Then there is funds specifically available for technology acquisition. Fund is available for innovation and also rewarding fund is available for recurring expenditure. Similarly, crisis management fund is there. It's one of the uniqueness That means whenever they are facing some problem, the crisis management fund from which it is supported and marketing support, that is very unique. You know, almost all the government services which is outsourced to different agencies are now outsourced to all these women. So that is the market which they are getting. Then clustering and networking based on the activities which they are doing. So I will introduce you some of the type of enterprises, startups initiated by these women. The first one is connected with the social startup, because in Kerala more of service oriented programs are thriving than the productive activities. She lodges or working women's hostels. These hostels or facilities are primarily run by these women enterprises as enterprise. Then we need lot of women in the houses, not only in the urban areas to support the people, but also in the rural areas. So they have a group which provides these household servants. And you know the labor cost is 350 rupees per day. In my house, my mother is paying 350 rupees for the cook. At the same time, once in 3 weeks, a lady comes for cleaning and she charges 400 rupees. That also they finish the work, then they go. But my mother is very old, she is thinking of 50 years ago the situation, and she says, you have to come at 6 o'clock and be there up to 6 o'clock. She will come at 7 and 2 o'clock she wanted to go. And she will ask, is there any more work? Tell me, I will do. If there is no work, I wanted to go. So that is a change. And also old age care. You know, Kerala, you know, the life expectancy is very high. We have old age homes and also in the houses. Many people, parents are in home and the children are working different places. So we need a lot of home nurses. That is also provided by these groups. Then they are running daycare. And also ductwell cleaning unit, that means water resources management. This is one example. Whatever the service we need in our household or village, just call them, they will come and do the work, you have to pay the charges. That also done by these groups. And travel services, we have a shared taxis and also the three wheelers also run by them. In addition to that, recently they started bus services, all run by these women. Then the next type of enterprises is service providers to government. That's what I said. Whatever the government services available, they entrust to them. Recently we have started this Kochi Metro rail service. All the work, including ticketing, cleaning, all the work is done by these women. They have been entrusted to this work. They have been very well trained and then placed. That is the thing. And also electronic seva kendra, all the online work which people wanted to do, is done by these women groups in the Akshaya Kendras. Similarly, if I said parking management, we have parking, normally it is in railway station and bus station, contract taken by different agencies. Now everything in every offices, every places is done by, managed by these women groups. So they are doing this work. Similarly, IT enterprises. IT enterprises is this data entry centers also are there and data processing units are also there. Actually, these are all government work. Government work, survey work is given to these women. They do the survey, they do the data entry, they do the processing. Everything is entrusted to them. Because they cannot compete with our international open market. So this is the, what all we have, that is being given to them. Then the other type of enterprises is suppliers to government. What is government required? Those things are produced by this women group and given to government. You know, we have Anganwadis, that is this kindergartens, you know, it's there in every panchayat. They are provided by Nutrimix. You know, the earlier government is buying Horlicks type of things from different agencies. Now we have a product called a Nutrimix, which is produced by this woman and they are supplying to the Anganwadis. We have 368 such micro enterprises and 3,680 jobs are created. They are regularly catering 3,000 Anganwadis. So no more Horlicks or anything is bought. It is produced by our women and also supplied to the Anganwadis. Then of course we have a number of traditional women enterprises connected with the primarily many value addition units and also lease land farming. You know, there are uncultivated land is hired by this group of women and they are primarily cultivating vegetables and tuber crops. A number of tailoring units, not small tailoring units, those tailoring units stitching uniform. uniforms of the school children and all. Then of course they are running napkin units producing, and also RO plants, water supply plants, and construction units. They also do the construction work, I mean the minimal level of construction work, and also organic manure units are some of the examples. So this is the one which is going at the government level. We have this Kudumbashree unit in every district. We have 14 districts, and in most of the districts, only the district coordinator is the government officer. Rest of them are from the NGOs and other expertise available there. We are also using the retired people as experts to use their services. Now with the Mitraniketan experience, over the last many years, Mitraniketan is working and giving lot of skill development training programs, and we have many success and many failures, because in the case of rural enterprises, we should be behind them, otherwise there is always a drop. But you know how we are doing is, we will now, currently we are searching these household enterprises. There are many women, they are doing by themselves some sort of small production and sales. We identify such those people and upgrading their skills and promoting them to become a good entrepreneur. That's what we are doing. That become more successful than calling a group of women or group of people, training them, ask them to start enterprises. So this is the methodology currently we are adopted. Then of course we conducted regular orientation program in environment development, I mean enterprise development. Then identify the potential entrepreneurs and giving advanced training program. That depends on the project. And also then what we do is, we provide from our core support project and all projects the minimum support to four startups. If they come up very well, then we link with financial institutions and government schemes and market. This is how we are going ahead. I'll show you some pictures. This is the general orientation program on rural enterprises we are giving always. This is connected with this bank meeting or something like that. And all these women know these general training programs of tailoring, bag making, soap making, candle making, and all those things are going part of it. Now we are specializing one item is called jackfruit, which I will tell you about that. So this is mostly jackfruit based value addition. You know, jackfruit is plenty available during season, from especially 3-4 months in a year during summer months. From one tree alone, we will get at least 200 to 300 kilograms of jackfruit. Almost half of them are being wasted. But now technology is available, we can make a number of value-added products and also store these jackfruit as pulp or dried product. This is what we are now promoting. Mitraniketan is engaged in that work. We have a few units promoted in tribal villages also. These are some of the photographs of our tribal group getting trained. And these are the products which they are producing on a smaller level, and also they are selling a lot of products during different exhibitions and all. Currently, we are promoting them to identify a few products and standardize and promote it. Especially when you go to Sri Lanka, Thailand and all, we can see minimal processed vegetables, jackfruits selling as vegetables in the open market, you know, supermarkets and all. That's what we are trying to promote. And also in all these technologies, all these programs, we need science, we need technical support. We always link with different institutions. This is a linkage we are doing with the University of Agriculture Sciences in Bangalore. And we availed 4 of their technologies. Because when we wanted to market it on a higher, large scale, then we need technical backup. So this is our staff who are getting trained in University of Agriculture Sciences in Bangalore. It's also the same thing. So these are the 3-4 products which we have produced using the technology from the Agriculture Sciences Bangalore. Actually this technology we know that, but when we are marketing it, we need some scientific backup support. That is the reason. So women are being trained in different skills, you know. These are some of the artistic pottery related training programs. This is bakery, and also that is the coconut fiber. Coconut fiber is another thing. Plenty of coconut is available. Coconut husk is being wasted. Now we are again started that activity of extracting coconut fiber and making coir, you know, the yarn. Then also making a lot of value-added products. Again, people conscious of environment and not used to buy this. But unfortunately, all these pottery, now replaced with plastic, so there is a problem in the market. And also these are also related different training programs which women can do in their spare times, and we collect all those things, pool and market, so they will get dividend out of that. So our experience in promoting enterprises is primarily we focus on local resource-based skill development. One example I told you, during season plenty of jackfruit is available, then banana is available, then coconut is available. What is the local resource available at one area? We develop the skills of the people of that area and we help them to market. In that way we are promoting these things, you know. Some of these old things which we are doing again, like poultry. Then of course we promote the clusters, groups at different places to support them. Similarly, farmers group orientation, because they can promote startup agri-based business. And also we help them with the business plan development and also continuous follow-up. That is also very important. So this is one of the very successful group which we have promoted, story of women from the village, forest village. There are 19 women. This is one of the projects supported by DST. We have promoted 4 such groups. This is one of the groups. There are 19 tribal women. You can see this picture very well. This is the jackfruit tree with a lot of jackfruits. You know, these women are living in the forest area. Plenty of jackfruits available. So they have been trained in all these processing technologies, mainly storing, pulping and also storing all these fruits. And also around the year they can make different products and market. So only thing is, it's related to the cost. If you increase the quality, there is market, but then you always get less prices. The quality and pricing is always a problem, but this is one of the successful group and they have got 3-4 awards for their performance. So we also continuously doing research. These are all jackfruit bars which is produced in our, we have a nodal center where research is also going. All the centers in Mitraniketan is called the training and production centers. We do training as well as production, then only it is being sustained. So this is one of the value-added products from banana powder. So this is a baby food. From banana powder we are making 3 different types of baby food which is also being marketed. This is one of the things. This is the jackfruit in the campus. This is a picture from other place. Plenty available. You know, in Tamil Nadu and all, they are very clever. They will crop a few things, then you will get a good. Then banana. Kerala, around the year you get a number of banana varieties. Plenty available. We consume a lot of banana, but there is a lot of scope for value addition also. And this is the jackfruit ready to cook vegetables. You know, tender cooked jackfruit you can use as vegetables, but if I give you 5 kilograms of jackfruit, you will find it very difficult to cut and all. So we cut, process everything, there is a minimal processing, then send to the market. So there is no wastage and you will get money. And of course, jackfruit jam as such you cannot make, it's only a mixed fruit jam. And this is one of the things, ready to serve jackfruit juice. There is a lot of demand for this, but our production cost itself is 30 rupees. So we can't sell more than that, you know. So the cost reduction is one of the issues, but this is very good. There is demand. We are now supplying in the local market only, just to be taken. Similarly, jackfruit ice cream is also very good. So we have a bakery also. In the case of bakery also, we train the people and mostly promoting as workers, because the demand for bakers are too high. I told you the cost of a baker is 700 to 1200. We have a very good bakery. We produce a lot of things. We train a number of people. This is a jackfruit based cake. And the rural enterprises which we promoted is homestead farms, poultry units, mushroom units. These are the different types of units promoted. But homestead farm also we consider as a rural enterprises. You know, homestead farm is, you know, that in the house itself and the land available, you can plant a number of vegetables and fruits and different integrated things. So that the production is primarily for consumption. After the rest you can sell it. You know, that is the thing which we have promoted. experience in relation to the, this is the last slide, don't worry. In relation to microenterprises, promotion is the cost of the labor. The thing is, people think that I have to produce the product, wait, get into the market, sell it, then I get the money, then we have to share. Rather than I go directly for work, I will easily get the money in the evening. That is the thing, that is the problem. So some people who don't want to go to the village and work, they are interested in enterprises. Then of course, when the problem is, if the rural enterprises have 10 members, the income is very limited to share. Similarly, difficult to compete in terms of banking, you know, the open market, you know, all these problems related to quality and price. And there are markets available, especially through exhibitions and related. One of the things I wanted to tell you is how we train the entrepreneurs. We are not only training them in our nodal center, not only in the village, but we take these trainees to the exhibitions when it is there. So our trainer is also been there in the exhibition store, where training, production is also, and also sales, both training programs will go at a time. So we continuously promote household enterprises which become successful. Similarly, the enterprise behind, if we are behind, that also thrives. Thank you. This is for the interest.